Android users have visual, physical, or age-related limitations that prevent them from fully seeing or using a touchscreen, or hearing loss that makes it difficult to perceive audible alerts. I'm Joanna Smith, and I want to help you understand how much you can gain with three basic accessibility considerations, because a few small changes to your app can make it accessible to the majority of users. Not all Android users are able to interact with their devices in the same ways, but it is important to make sure that your app is usable by everyone. Your app's accessibility can affect your number of installs, the quality of reviews for your app, and how long your users will stick with you. Android makes it straightforward for you to create accessible apps because it already gives you APIs for text-to-speech, haptic feedback, gesture navigation, trackball, and directional pad navigation. And there are three basic checks that you should make before releasing any app that will cover the majority of accessibility scenarios. And while there are hundreds of improvements you could make, it turns out that focusing on these three will take you most of the way. First, provide content descriptions for user interface components that do not have visible text. This is especially important for image button, image view, and checkbox components because these elements often influence the flow of the app. So use the Android content description layout attribute or the set content description method to provide this information to the device's accessibility services so that they can present it to the user. And to limit distractions in your app flow, set the content description of decorative graphics to null. I recommend using the TalkBack app to test each component for logical content descriptions and to be certain that nothing in your app surprises you. Second, make sure that users can navigate your screen layouts using hardware-based or software directional controls, such as D-pads, trackballs, keyboards, and navigation gestures. You should be confident that your app will support all of these, so be sure to test your app. There are several apps out there that will help you simulate these hardware controls for you, such as the eyes-free keyboard, so that you can be certain that every critical UI element is reachable and focusable. When a user cannot simply tap on the component they care about, it becomes clear that the order of each component is important. So check your app for logical transitions and adjust the focus order as needed. You can control the focus order by setting elements to focusable or not, and explicitly stating which element should follow along a direction. Finally, you should always provide feedback using more than one mechanism. Combine audio feedback with a secondary feedback mechanism to support users who are deaf or hard of hearing. For example, a sound alert for the arrival of a message must be accompanied by a system notification, haptic feedback if available, or some other visual cue. Now, as I said earlier, these three checks will make your app mostly accessible. But if you'd like to dive deeper into our checklist, you should check out the documentation. There are plenty of other considerations, and you can even create your own custom view controls and accessibility services. Now, hopefully these changes will help your app grow, but if you want to see what other improvements you can make, check out the rest of our Android Development Patterns content and consider joining the G+ community for tips, tricks, and help. But most importantly, just continue to build better apps.